Good morning, class. Children, today we shall start a very important topic of for this chapter, Constitution Design, that is Constituent Assembly. So today we will go through what were the important values, what were the important principles which has been taken from the different nations and then we have adopted in our Constitution. I think this topic is clear and the Constituent Assembly is very important. The chairman of the Constituent Assembly was Dr. Rajendra Prasad and the chairman of the drafting committee, chairman of the drafting committee of the Constitution was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. You have to underline these important things and then the Constituent Assembly was again divided into two parts after the partition of India. Okay? And we have gone through the partition ke baad jo hai wo division ho gaya Constituent Assembly mein. The members were 389 and then it was divided into 299 members for India. Okay, and the assembly adopted the constitution on 26 November 1949. We have completed, actually we have completed our constitution on 26 November 1949 and it was adopted. That is why we celebrate 26 November as our constitution day. But we have adopted, means the constitution came into effect, not adopted, came into effect on January 26, 1950. So question can come why we have adopted 26 January 1950 for the celebration of Republic Day. Okay, so I will ask you at the end of the chapter, ki humne ye 26 January ko hi kyun select kiya tha, main baad mein aapse puchungi. Now look at the, some of the leaders, some members of the Constituent Assembly, that they were Dr. Rajendra Prasad, B.R. Ambedkar, who was the chairman of the drafting committee hai, and the chairman of the Constituent Assembly was Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Okay? Then why should we accept the constitution made by the Constituent Assembly more than 69 years? Okay, hame constitution kyun jo hai wo accept karna chahiye? Why should we accept the constitution? Is there anyone who can speak? Almost more than 70 years we have completed for being a democratic, being a republican country, we have completed more than 69 years. So why should we accept constitution? Kyun hame accept karna chahiye? Many countries in the world have had to rewrite their constitution afresh because the basic rules were not accepted to all the social groups or political parties. Children, agar hum dusri countries se compare karte hain to humne apne constitution ko kabhi change nahi kiya. Kuch aise countries hain jinhone ki constitution ko boycott bhi kar diya and then they have rewrite their constitution. But so far India has never boycotted constitution and we have never rewrite constitution. Yes, wherever we need changes according to the times, we have modified our constitution, right? So that is why we have accepted constitution that was made by the Constituent Assembly. We actually respected whatever principles they have adopted in the constitution. Okay, so when they made constitution, they have done a lot of research on their needs at that time according. And जो है वो चेंज हो रहा है, मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड में हमारी रिक्वायरमेंट्स चेंज हो चुकी हैं, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग हमें जहाँ जहाँ चेंज करने की जरूरत लगती है वहाँ गवर्नमेंट जो है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को अमेंड कर सकती है. इन सम अदर कंट्रीज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एग्जिस्ट एज अ मियर पीस ऑफ पेपर. ओके, नो वन एक्चुअली फॉलोज इट. द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज डिफरेंट. नो लार्ज सोशल ग्रुप और पॉलिटिकल पार्टी हैज एवर क्वेश्चन the legitimacy of the constitution itself. As we have already discussed children, that constitution एक हम sacred book कह सकते हैं, ठीक है? अभी तक कोई भी ऐसा 70 years republican होने के बावजूद, ठीक है, इस 70 years में कभी भी कोई ऐसा social group या कोई political party ऐसी नहीं आई है जिसने कि questioning किया हो constitution की legitimacy पे, ठीक है? This is an unusual achievement for any constitution. Now, the Constituent Assembly represented the people of India. As we will see in NCERT books or in the first page of the Constitution, it is already mentioned that Constituent Assembly actually represents the country, represents the citizen of India. Like we have learned in French Revolution, I have given you one question. That was the preamble of the French Constitution. It was the Declaration of Basic Fundamental Rights, the first page of French Revolution. I have given you in tests also the first question. It was the law tablet which actually gives the first page, the preface of French Constitution. So similarly, the Constituent Assembly represented the people of India, people of our country. It was elected mainly by the members of the existing provincial legislatures. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे basically जो हमारी जो representatives होंगे, okay? First of all, basically मैं mechanism से start करती हूँ, थोड़ा सा deep study करने के लिए second point को. देखो, यहाँ पे represent कौन कर रहा है? लोग ही represent कर रहे हैं, republican form of government है. ठीक है, as we have learned in first chapter, democracy is for the people, by the people. So here government को represent कर कौन कर रहा है? लोग ही कर रहे हैं. On their behalf, on the behalf of the people, the members will be elected. ठीक है, members will be elected. मैं माइक को बोल रही हूँ, भी चुला के इतना. ओके, सो हियर पीपल विल रूल एंड ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द पीपल दे इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स विल रिप्रेजेंट. ठीक है, आर दीज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स विल रिप्रेजेंट दैट पर्टिकुलर रीजन, जिस रीजन से वो सिलेक्ट होके आए हैं. ठीक है, जहाँ के लोगों ने उनको वोट दिया है, मेजोरिटी में जहाँ पे जीत मिली है, उस रीजन को वो रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे. That is the meaning of second point. Okay, then third point, this ensured a fair geographical share of members from all the regions of the country. यानी कि हमने जो constituencies पढ़ी हैं पिछले classes में, हर एक region से, हर एक constituency से एक particular member represent करेगा ही करेगा parliament में. ठीक है, उनकी क्या needs हैं, उनकी क्या welfare है, उनकी aspirations को represent करेगा. ठीक है, the assembly representing members from different language, caste, class, religions and occupations. This is clearly mentioned in the law book, in the constitution में clearly mentioned है. Even the seats, sometime, you know, we can say after 5 years, ऐसा schedule change होता रहता है कि कोई particular schedule caste या schedule tribes के लिए जो seats हैं, वो reserve किए जाए. The Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic, open and consensus manner. Means यहाँ पे Constituent Assembly जो थी वो एक open discussion में consensus पे based, यानी mutual consensus, यानी जिसमें आपसी सहमति हो, differences नहीं हो. ठीक है, आपस में जिसमें सब लोग agree हो जाएं, एक दूसरे से, ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए तो हाँ हम agree नहीं है और अपनी मर्जी से छाप दो फिर constitution कुछ भी बना लो, ऐसा नहीं. ठीक है, जिसमें consensus हो, जिसमें सभी की mutual understanding हो, सब लोग एक बात पे सहमत हो जाए, ऐसे manner पे constitution काम करेगी. First, some basic principles were decided and agreed upon. ठीक है, इन सभी चीजों का ध्यान रखा गया कि हर एक region से, constituency से represent करे, उनके welfare, उनकी needs को represent करे, आपसी सहमति हो, consensus हो लोगों में. First and some basic principles were decided and agreed upon. कुछ ऐसे principles already जिसमें कि लोग agreed थे. Then a drafting committee chaired by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. Okay, जैसे मैं screen call करती हूँ, आप लोग अपना camera off करके सो जाते हैं. ठीक है, यहाँ पर कुछ लोग हैं जो सिर्फ लगता है कि लंच आप लोगों को डांट खाने में शायद बहुत मजा आता है, आप लोगों को यहाँ वाली भाषा समझ में नहीं आती है ना? भाई कैमरा ऑन करके बैठे हो तो कोई प्रॉब्लम है? खा रहे हैं तुम्हें कोई? ऑन कर लो कैमरा. जैसे स्विच ऑन करो स्क्रीन पे, प्रेजेंटेशन पे आप लोग अपना कैमरा ऑफ कर देते हैं. 45 से 43 स्टूडेंट हो गए, दो बच्चे और भाग गए, इसको नींद आ रही थी बेटा. हर एक बच्चा जो है ना आगे चल के इंजीनियर या डॉक्टर बन सकता है और बनना भी चाहिए. ठीक है, लेकिन कुछ स्टूडेंट ऐसे जरूर होंगे जिनके पास शायद ये दोनों ऑप्शन ना हो, डॉक्टर और इंजीनियर बनने के. तो काइंडली फोकस ऑन योर स्टडीज. ठीक है, तब आपके पास एक ही ऑप्शन होगा, वो होगा ह्यूमैनिटीज. social science subject. Okay. अब जो भी बच्चा ऑफ करेगा ना, मैं उसको रिमूव कर दूंगी क्लास से, और पूरे हफ्ते भर के लिए रिमूव रहेगा.
A
ब्लर, थोड़ा सा ब्लर आया है स्क्रीन पे के कृष्णा टी कृष्णा बचारी एंड देन दुर्गा भीष्म, ठीक है, एंड सुक्ला एंड सरोजिनी नायडू, ये नेम्स दिए हैं आपके बुक में भी है, हम बुक में आते हैं फिर से एनसीईआरटी में.